The Philippines' national government debt swells to a new high of over 9 trillion pesos in June amid the huge spending needed to address the COVID-19 pandemic and its impact to the local economy. In just a month, the country's total debt stock increased by 163 billion pesos as of end June, with both local and foreign borrowings increasing. Program loans amounted to 216 billion pesos during the period, which includes 53 billion pesos in concessional loans from multilateral creditors to fund programs against the health crisis. Despite the jump, Philippine Central Bank Governor Benjamin Diokno says the country's external debt profile remains manageable.
It is worth noting that the Philippines' external debt metrics have steadily improved, with a significant decline in the external debt to GDP ratio from 59.7%. Our debt to GDP ratio remains one of the lowest among ASEAN member countries.
While the ballooning government debt has been attributed to a surge in spending due to the pandemic, some senators are now urging state auditors to review COVID-19 programs amid alleged anomalies. Allegations of overpricing have marred the implementation of the Bayanihan to Heal as One Act, the primary law that outlined government's initial response to the pandemic. It also allowed President Rodrigo Duterte to realign billions of pesos for government's coronavirus response with exemptions to the usual bidding process. The resolution filed by Senator Riza Hontiveros and signed by six other senators cites, for one, the purchase of imported COVID-19 testing kits, which are more expensive than the ones made locally. Hontiveros also questions where funds for personal protective equipment went, since many health workers and frontliners continue to get sick due to a lack of PPEs. The resolution urges the Commission on Audit to present its findings before Congress deliberates on the 2021 budget. But amid these calls, the Senate has also approved another measure to fund the country's COVID-19 recovery plan. The proposed Bayanihan to Recover as One Act will provide 140 billion pesos to ramp up the response to the health crisis. It will also assist businesses and workers who have been impacted by the pandemic.
Of course, being prudent about it, we didn't want the Bayanihan to be vetoed. I laud the House of Representatives for doing a 1.3 billion budget, but if you ask the DOH about it, they will not agree to it. So we're in a stalemate. So what we decided to do in the Senate, let's pass a version with the cap of the DOF, go into BICAM, and let's haggle with the Department of Finance.
But members of the House of Representatives flagging the Senate-approved bill as they insist the 1.3 trillion peso stimulus package approved by the lower house. Local governments across the country also seeking ways to expedite the recovery in their areas. A group of the country's local chief executives are asking the Land Bank of the Philippines for lower interest rates in its recently launched 10 billion peso loan program for local government units.
Challenge ko sa Land Bank ngayon is to look for, you know, funds that we can allocate for this at lower interest rate.
The program offers loans to local governments at an interest rate of 4.5%, but officials are asking for a 3.5% rate to help their areas recover faster from the pandemic. Bruce Rodriguez, ABS-CBN News.